Hello, my beautiful YouTube and internet friends. My channel is all about showing you how you can do your art journaling, mixed media and crafting on a low budget. My name is Ilona, better known on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and WordPress as Picture for Life. Every Thursday you will find new and free easy tutorial videos for art journaling and mixed media. Subscribe to my channel to follow me on my creative journey. I'm all about keeping it simple. Even if it looks difficult, it's not. Trust me. I make easy to follow process tutorial videos for art journaling and mixed media. So if you like to see more low budget, mixed media and art journaling, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon so you know when I upload a new video. You can also follow me on Facebook, Instagram and I have a blog on WordPress. So join me for a new, fun and low-budget mixed media project. Today's project started in 2016. I had bought some leather stencils and the letters you see on this page are all the push-out stuff from the stencils. And I just arranged them on a page and never done anything with them. And then I wanted to try out some techniques and some materials. And I wanted to see how they react on a black background. And for some of the techniques, I needed to have lots of texture. So this page started with a little texture already. So what I did was, of course, because I wanted to test it on black backgrounds, make my whole page pitch black. And I used some black gesso to do that. And when I made my whole page black, I decided I wanted to have even more texture. So I took out a stencil and my modeling paste, which is just cheap wall filler. And I put that through my stencil and then I went over it with black again. So I had some metallic paints that I wanted to try out. And some are really cheap from a local low budget store. And I have a few that are by Cadence. I wanted to test all kinds of shimmery paints and materials and see what I could do with it, if you could use water with it or not, or all kinds of different things that I wanted to try out. So I started with a metallic paint in a bronze gold, just to see how shimmery it could get and if I could make a spray with it. First I started by just peeling off the lid and it had some paint on it, so I'm smearing that paint all over my page. So that's my first layer and then I'm adding just water to see how far I can dilute it. So I'm thinking this can handle pretty much water, so I might be able to make sprays out of this, which I'm trying to do later. And then I have a golden metallic paint from the same brand, and I try to make a star in the middle of my page to see how it looks. So then I also had just a little bottle with a really small nip. It was some kind of dropper for my eyes or something like that. And I wanted to test if I could make my paint so watery that I could write with it. So that's what I did. I just watered down some white paint, put it in this bottle. It is working, but if I squeeze too hard, the drops get too heavy and if I squeeze not enough, then it's too light. So it's gonna take a little bit of practice to get this right. Okay, so I know this is working, but I think it's too bright in the front. So I'm pushing it back by adding some black paint on it, over it again, and then taking a rag, getting some paint off so you can see my background through it a little bit. And then I'm having some different mica powders. I have a few that are from Ranger, but the blue one that I'm starting with is just, I don't know, I picked it up at in the makeup section. So this one comes out of the makeup section and I went back later, but they did not sell them anymore. Bummer. So I only have a black one and a blue one. And what I want to know is, how does this react on a dark background? Does it give me the effect that it's a dark night sky or not? And will this hold when I put water on it? That's also something I wanted to know. So first of all, I'm going to try to make a kind of a night sky by brushing it on with a the paintbrush. Then I'm testing out my ringer. These ones are actually only working on dark backgrounds. They are white, but it has this shimmer in it. I have them in a few colors, and this is the purple color. Then I add more blue, and now you can see me that I mist with water to see what it does. And it does hold, so perfect. And that's kind of where this page ended last year. So I started in 2016 or 17, I don't remember. But last year around Christmas I remember doing this, testing things out. And then this year I had some other metallic paints, and they came from a local budget store here in the Netherlands. And I wanted to try out how they reacted on a black background. I remembered this page and I thought I could do an angel on top of here. So I'm just drawing very lightly a head and some kind of a body shape. And then I'm taking just my fingers and some paint. And you see this paint is really translucent. And at first it's just kind of like a shadow in the back. And I really wanted to be a little bit more visible, like an angel. So I'm adding on my paints a little bit heavier. I started with a mint green and a light blue, and I also used a pearl color. And I keep adding paints and trying stuff out. And it's pretty difficult to see, but I'm doing the wings and kind of it doesn't feel like it's alive, sort of. And then I'm taking a gold because I thought, well, it's kind of not defined that this is a body and this is wings. So let's try to define that by using a gold color. And I'm trying really lightly to add in the golds. First around the body and around the wings. But then I also drag the color in inside the body and inside the wings. And it's really hard to see on this little small screen that I'm looking at when I'm editing this. But in real life, and I'm not sure if I captured that on my photograph, but in real life it's really, really gorgeous, and it shimmers like crazy on the page. To give it even more definition, I also added some detail with some white paint pen, sort of like a Posca pen. But I really thought that was too white. So then I took a white metallic paint pen and I add in even more details. And in the picture they show up much, much softer than in my video. I don't know why. And for the last detail I make some stars, and that's just it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you back with my next video. Don't forget to subscribe.